Hi, I'd like to introduce you to Marc, who's at my house for a first time tart that we're gonna make, but he's really a good cook. So I've done something that's simple. I've already made the dough, and we're doing a pear tart. So I already have the dough made. So come on over here. Now you haven't really touched dough very much.
Not a lot, no.
Okay.
First time really.
You're okay with this?
Stuff. Yeah,
you're
I think okay. I'll manage.
So I'm gonna start and, you know, using our hands, because we both washed our hands is good.
Yeah.
So we're gonna leave a little peripheral edge because we'll fold up.
Okay.
So why don't we leave an edge about 2 inches and just start piling it up any way you want. Just leaving a little border. Yeah, just go for it. Because imperfect is good.
So what's in the dough here?
Well, I did flour, butter, and the Cuisinart kind of did the whole, and a little bit of water. So my recipe makes enough for two whole pies or 2 small galettes.
And there's, you said there's cinnamon and sugar and stuff.
I know you can smell that. See,
yeah.
You got a good nose. I have some sugar and a little bit of cinnamon. I didn't want to overwhelm it with cinnamon, you know. And I think that's looking like perfect.
That's good.
All right, here.
Yeah.
You have some. Don't go away.
Nope.
Just sprinkle.
Just on top like that?
Yeah, anywhere. And what's going to happen, you know, you could use raisins, but I love cranberries, and I think the color is great.
Yeah. It's good for Thanksgiving, too.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. So, Marc.
It's the next step here.
We're going to fold it over. Let me just start you a little bit, and
yeah.
It's easy. Instead of using your hands, I get a little spatula, and
okay.
I'll take the second fold, and then you're going to do it. Just a little bit like that, and it doesn't, so work it, and while you're doing that, just get in there and turn it over like you're the boss, you know?
Okay. Are we making like little pleats and stuff too?
Yes, exactly.
Okay.
All right, now I'm just going to quickly throw in a little bit of butter for extra flavor, you know.
Oh, butter is great.
Yeah, butter, the real stuff, never use the fake stuff.
Always.
And I'm gonna start you with this. I took a little bit of an egg yolk and put some milk in it, and I want the crust to be very golden brown. So literally, just paint, don't worry about it, but get most of the dough, just dab it.
Okay.
And be quick about it. I say quick because I don't want the dough to get too soft.
Okay, I always see this trick on like cooking shows and stuff. What is it, just for keeping it golden or?
Well, actually the egg wash is called does make it extra golden, and we're going to, after you're done with that, we're going to bleed some sugar on, so when it bakes it gets that wonderful you'll just see what it looks like.
Okay.
Yeah.
And the sugar too.
Yeah. What I do is I put it in my hands and I go like so. So here, have some sugar.
All right.
And just be generous.
Only on the edges, or can we put some in the middle too?
Yeah, just in the middle is good.
Okay.
You know, I always say, if you really don't want to eat sweets, then you don't eat sweets, right?
Right.
Well, then how deep is that? Okay. So I've already preheated the oven, and it's going to go in for a typical galette is about 40 minutes, and this is
right.
at 350, and
okay.
this works well because I happen to have this wonderful convection oven which moves the air
nice.
Around. So
all
here
right.
we go.
Should I get the door for you?
Yep. It was preheated. I'll just put it back in. So. Okay, we are done.
All right.
So, thank you so much.
Absolutely.
Yeah, you'll see what happens in the end.
I'm excited to see this.
I know.
Yeah.
And he's going to be eating. And me too.
Oh,
okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
See
you in a minute.
Okay. This looks awesome.
It's been smelling wonderful for a while.
Oh, I know.
Oh.
Okay.
I think you're a full-fledged baker now.
Well,
let me help you hold it. And just scoot on to the plate. I'll go close. Here, I'll hold it up.
Yeah.
You got it. Move it on over.
Mm-hmm.
Perfect.
All right.
Yes.
Not
put it
bad.
Down. And I think it has to cool for at least a good, you know, half hour or so.
Okay.
But see what the egg wash did. Look how beautiful that is.
Oh, yeah.
And it bled and it, you know.
That's
and the
nice.
Cranberries.
Oh, the sugar looks great. The cranberries are looking great on
top.
Yeah,
I think so.
Yeah.
I think what I'm thinking about is fresh cranberries tend to bleed.
Oh, yeah.
And these are the dried ones, which I always have.
So not a lot of juice is getting out of them.
Yes, exactly. Okay. So we're going to eat it each way. Anyway, it is.
All right. You know? I'm excited for it. Okay. Definitely.
Excellent. You did a great job.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Well, thank you for showing me how to do this.
Okay. And next time you show me how to cook something else.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah. I have a few things I can show you.
I would be happy if you did that.
Yeah.